afternoon. This isolation thing and being shut in and all that is, I don't know what it's doing to my brain, but something is just, it's just not right. Maybe it's never been right. But I woke up this morning, and don't agree with me, Rebecca, I seen you shaking your head. I woke up this morning and had this song on my mind. It's a poem, and it's a song. And it actually was on my mind when I woke up this morning, and I sat in the computer room and just wrote all this stuff out. So this is an old song, and it's about a preacher. It's about a preacher that possibly could have lived in Maine. I'm not sure if that's when the song was written. And it's possible it's a story about this preacher in Maine, or preachers in Maine, and it could have been the Jones Boys. We're not sure. I just never looked up who wrote the song, but it could be about the Jones Boys. It's a poem and a song. So bear with me, laugh, cry, call the pastor, have him kick me out, whatever it is. All right. Here we go. The preacher went out a-hunting. It was on a Sunday morn. It was against his religion, but he took his shotgun along. He got himself a mess of mighty fine quail and one old scraggly hare. And on the way home, he crossed the path of a great big grizzly bear. Well, the bear got down looking ready to charge. The preacher never seen nothing quite that large. They looked at each other right smack in the eye. Didn't take that preacher long to say bye. The preacher, he run till he spotted a tree. Up in that tree where I ought to be. By the time that bear made a grab for him, the preacher was sitting on the top of that limb. Scared to death, he turned about. He looked to the sky and began to shout, "Hey, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the bottom of the lion's den. You delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, and then the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, so the good book so declares. Hey, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't help that bear. Y'all look out, preacher." Well, about that time, the limb broke off, and the preacher came tumbling down. Had a straight razor out of his pocket. By the time he lit on the ground, he'd landed on his feet right in front of that bear, and Lord, that was an awful fight. The preacher and the bear and the razor and the hare flying from left to right. Well, first they were up and then they were down, the preacher and the bear running round and round. The bear, he roared, and the preacher, he groaned. He was having a tough time holding his own. He said, "Lord, if I get out of here alive, to the good book I'll abide. Hey, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the bottom of the lion's den. You delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, and then the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, so the good book so declares. Hey, Lord, if you can't help me, for goodness sake, don't help that bear." Well, you know, that was the first time that the words of 6 foot apart was ever spoke. Take the words of that preacher, and here's an addition that I put to that song today. "Hey, Lord, you delivered Daniel from the lion's den. You delivered Jonah from the belly of the whale, and then the Hebrew children from the fiery furnace, so the good book so declares." Hold on. "Hey, Lord, please help me, and for goodness sake, don't help that COVID bear." That's all, folks.
That's all, folks. That's great.
I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, I cannot bear my burdens alone. I must tell Jesus, I must tell Jesus, Jesus can help me, Jesus alone. When you're trusting in His word, hearken to the voice of God today.